Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Happy New Year! I hope you guys had a wonderful, wonderful holiday season and a wonderful new year. This is officially my very first video being filmed in the new year, so I'm very, very excited for this one. I wanted to come up with an idea first to introduce 2018 for you guys and not just jump right into reviews or best of the year kind of video. So this may be a little bit of a chatty video. I'm gonna try to keep it as quick as possible. I do have some things to share with you guys today, as you can see from the title. But before we get into it, if you're new to my channel, welcome to the family. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video if you do like it, and let's get on with the video. Now, as you guys can see from the title, I am here to share with you guys products that I did not purchase in the year of 2017. As I was going through my whole entire inventory and just seeing what's really going to fit for me this year, what I wanted to pan, so on and so forth, I realized that there were some products I didn't even bother to purchase any of the past year. So I wanted to share with you guys. Can you tell I'm a little rusty? I haven't filmed in about 10 days because I've pre-recorded a lot. Anyway, but I wanted to share with you guys, considering I always share with you guys my hauls, and these are products that I haven't really hauled throughout the year of 2017. The first one that I have is primers. Any face primers? I haven't purchased a face primer in at least 2 years. I finished my full-size one last year in a panning project, and I haven't purchased a full-size one. I am currently using the deluxe sample size to really see which one I want to invest my money in, but I have been more concentrated on my skincare, which in turn is why I haven't really purchased a primer, because it all starts with your skin. So my skin is doing so much better that I really don't need to have a hardcore primer to work with my foundation, if that makes any sense. Next product that I haven't purchased is eyeshadow primers. It takes a long time for me to use an eyeshadow primer, and the ones that I have, I have so many sample size ones that came with palettes and so on and so forth. I don't need to buy an eyeshadow primer for years. I haven't purchased one in 2 years, and I'm currently trying to use Milani one that is huge for what you get for, and I love it. So I don't think I'm gonna purchase an eyeshadow primer in a very long time as well. Next up is brow products. I don't need a lot of brow products for my brows. Obviously, you guys can see they're pretty full on their own. So I tend to use what I have. I am using pencils that I did purchase maybe like 3 years ago from Avon. They were like $1.99. Really great pencils. They work well on my brows. I don't need anything hardcore, so I love these brow products. And I got a bunch of deluxe sample size of products with gift with purchases. So it seems like I'm not going to buy a lot of brow products for a very long time. Eyeliners. I decluttered so much last year, and one of them being eyeliners. I decluttered a ton of my eyeliners because I knew I wasn't going to go through them, and I have become pickier and pickier with things in my waterline. I'm currently testing out the ones that I did officially keep to see if they're still staying in my collection. I haven't purchased an eyeliner, I would say, in about 3 to 4 years because I'm just using what I have. I've gotten a lot of them throughout the years as gifts or with palettes and so on and so forth. So I'm really narrowing down at least the black ones to see which ones I really love. I have a very finicky waterline, and I just want to pick one that works well, that I don't have to babysit or have to worry about it getting everywhere. Another one is mascaras. Mascaras I haven't purchased in about 3 years. I have so many deluxe sample size mascaras, I do not need to buy any. And on top of that, I have wonderful friends and family that have gifted me some over the past few years. So I'm just working through my collection. I have found amazing ones throughout my collection, and I have written them down just so I know in the future I can purchase the full size of them. Another one is lip liners. I don't need lip liners. I go through them pretty quickly, but I don't need them. You don't need a ton. You can pick a few colors that go with a large range of lip colors. So I don't need to buy any. I haven't purchased any in about 2 years, and I'm good with what I have. Lip gloss. I decluttered so many of my lip glosses. It's ridiculous. I am growing and going back to lip glosses, but I'm happy that my lip glosses are under 20. I have under 20 lip glosses, and they're all deluxe sample size with the exception of one. I did get some for Christmas, but I didn't get a ton, and they're colors that I know I'm going to absolutely love and use. So I'm happy with what I have, and I haven't purchased any. I have, but for gifts, not for myself. Bronzers. I can't remember the last time that I really enjoyed and purchased a bronzer. I've been going through my collection of bronzers, really picking out the ones that I like. I have decluttered a heck of a lot of bronzers, and the ones that I have kept, I'm planning on using up, and they're easy for me to use up. I really like the ones that I have, and I haven't purchased any in a very long time. Unless they come in palette forms, that's the only way I've gotten bronzers. Gel liners, liquid liners, any of those types, I can't remember the last time I purchased one. As you guys can see, it takes about 2 years for me to pan a gel liner, and I am in love with gel liners. I'm trying to use my liquid pencils right now because I'm not a fan of them, but I'm trying to branch out and show you guys other things. So I am going through the ones that I have. They're all deluxe sample size, with the exception of one that I have purchased that's been sitting in there for a long time, and I'm trying to use that one up. Setting sprays. I've been getting a lot of these also with gift with purchases. I haven't purchased a setting spray in 2 years. I got sent the Scandinavia ones, and I love them. They're my all-time favorite ones, and I really enjoy them for doing for other people's makeup when I do their makeup as well as mine. It's a staple of mine. So if I ever run out of the ones that I have, I'll go and get those. But other than that, I haven't purchased any. Last two is lip balms. You guys, I haven't purchased a lip balm in a very long time either. I've just been working through what I have and really trying to see what I really like. And the last thing that I haven't purchased is nail polish. My goodness, it's been, I would say, going on 4 years with nail polish. It's truly been a very long time with nail polish. I'm not a nail polish fanatic, as you guys can see. The last 2 months, I really haven't painted my nails. I have been trying to get back into it, just to use what I have, because I really do like painting my nails. It's just very hard with small children to have the time to sit there and let them dry, because you know how children are. So those are the things that I haven't purchased in the year of 2017. As I have been looking through my collection, enjoying my collection, panning some stuff, really falling back in love, doing my shop, my stash, I have been realizing what I love, what I don't love. And that's the whole entire evolution, I guess, of a makeup lover, addict, whatever you want to call it. I just realized the things that I do love, the things that I'm not going to buy any more of, or the things that I really want to invest my money in. I have narrowed down my collection, with the exception of eyeshadows, you guys. Eyeshadows, you know, they're my thing. But I feel happy and content of how my collection looks today. I am truly enjoying it. I'm falling back in love with things that I have been loving. And I just wanted to share this with you guys to remind you guys that, you know, I'm realizing I don't need to purchase every single new release of things. And I have been doing so well with that. This year is going to be a major year for me and my family. So I really have to cut back on my spending. Eyeshadow palettes is the one thing that I'm going to let myself slide on. But if I do buy too many eyeshadow palettes, that means nothing else is allowed to be bought. But I am on a specific amount that in my mind I want to use. And if I don't buy anything for the month, I am happy with that. I am very, very pleased with how I am today as far as my mentality goes, as far as makeup. And I just encourage you guys, if you are having a hard time, it's not going to be overnight. This is not going to be an overnight thing. It's a little by little kind of step. I'm very happy with, you know, just everything that I have. I'm just really enjoying what I've gotten. And I feel like it's showing you guys something new, because I have enough to share with you guys a different look every day for the rest of the year. I still have a ton, but it's nowhere near what it was two or three years ago, and I'm very, very content with that. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. The next videos you guys will see will be my best in beauty. I will normally do 3 videos, as you guys know from the past years. I have tweaked the videos here and there because, as you guys know, I really cut back on my lip products, so I'm not going to have just one video dedicated to lip products, since I didn't buy that much. I think I purchased 2-3 things, that's it. So, and I'm trying to do that with the rest of my makeup that I have. It's just seeing what else I don't need to buy each year to see if maybe I can cut it back and enjoy what I have. So thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you for letting me go on this little rant that I wanted to share with you guys. I cannot wait to see what 2018 holds for us. I'm very, very excited. If you guys follow me on any social media, I keep my goals quiet to myself. And last year I wanted to hit 6,000 subscribers. I was short by 40 subscribers, 40. But that's still amazing because I really didn't think I was gonna make it. And I'm just so excited to know that I have you guys that wanna watch my videos take the time to out of your busy schedules just to come out and watch my 10-15 minute video. I love doing this. This is an amazing hobby for me. I've met amazing people. You guys just get me out of my normal everyday routine, and I really enjoy it. So thank you so much. I can't wait till 2018. You know, what is it gonna bring? I don't know, but I'm very excited. I have ideas, I have thoughts, I have plans, but you know that life just throws you curveballs, so I'm just gonna go with it and see where it takes me. A lot of you guys have also said that you love my content, and I love the fact that I have finally come to this place where I just do what I want to do. I am not looking at what everyone else is doing, and I love that. This is where I should have been from day one. And you know, once you start looking at what everyone else is doing, and you think that's the way to go, and then you realize that's just not you. And I'm happy to know that this is where I'm at, and I'm happy you guys love to see what I'm doing, and it's just, I'm just excited all the way around. So anyway, let me stop now before this becomes a 20-minute video. Thank you again for watching. I will catch you guys in my next video. Stay tuned for the best of beauty, and don't forget that a smile is the best makeup a girl can wear. Bye, guys.